For many people, the machinery industry conjures up images of grease and dirt and of drilling and grinding. That's why it has sometimes been called the black hands industry. But while having a machine as a companion all day may not seem exciting to some, this sector has been honed and refined and has now become a jewel in the crown of Taiwan's industries. Taiwan's machinery industry has grown from a family-based industry into a world-renowned center for the production of precision machinery. And it all goes back to machine tools 30 years ago.
那个年代在民国六十几年，民国七十几年的时候，台湾的这个传统的公积金能够大量的外销到美国去，外销到世界各地去。哦，这个最主要的关键就是讲，它效果好用嘛，大碗个万年嘛。
In 2007, the production value of Taiwan's machinery industry reached $28 billion. Every year, all manner of lathes, punching machines, and CNC machine tools bring in over $3 billion in foreign exchange reserves. Taiwan is the world's fourth largest exporter of machine tools after Japan, Germany, and Italy. Founded in 1954, Victor Taichung Machinery was Taiwan's first large-size machine tool factory. It began by manufacturing traditional machine tools and then shifted to the high value-added, low pollution and technology-intensive high-tech industry. The company epitomizes the growth of Taiwan's machinery industry.
We started making 两只手、两只脚，眼睛盯着这样子去做，去操作这台机器。但是大概就是20多年前就开始换成是用 NC 的，就是由电脑来控制。所以等于就是说，把一个老腮胡的经验放到电脑上面。过去曾经有过这种情形，一个老先生，他什么都不会，但是他买了一台这个 NC 车床呢，他只是就是把这个加工件放进去，门关起来。 按一个我们叫它 cycle start 启动的按钮，就是按这样，他每天做的工作就是把东西放进去，按一个按钮再拿出来，再放进去这样子的。他3个月以后来买第二台，老板问他说是哎怎么样啊？我一上这个用的好不好？他说哦，作战的气都的五级了。你这个要出几只？这个两只啊。
因为过去的传统的高速车床。 哦，还是一般的公积机，它大概一台只有20-30万的价值，但是进到了一个 CNC 加上电脑化的关系，所以它的整个附加价值大为提高。它现在大概一台平均的单价已经都高达快在1-2百万，所以等于是一个10倍数的一个金额的一个成长。它会形成两个族群的，就是中大型的公司，它的转型去做较客制化的物件，因为它的技术层次比较高。 那一般比较中小型，它就停留在做一些代工啦、OEM的，用大量生产的这种组装的模式在市场上竞争。
Flexibility, the ability to customize, and a complete system of satellite factories for processing have given Taiwan's machinery a highly competitive edge internationally.
Basically, 产官、鞋、盐、金呢，哈，通通要有参与了。而且呢，因为是一个国家跟一个国家的竞争，所以呢，上中下游的群聚是一个非常重要的。那台湾有一个很好的好处，就是台湾土地面积小，大家都集中在这个领域里，所以解决问题的速度会非常的快。
All of central Taiwan's universities, colleges, and industrial parks are within an hour's drive of one another. About 1,500 supporting companies produce parts, and the industry employs around 500,000 people. 1 out of 10 people here works in a machinery-related profession. And it is this comprehensive network that has helped Taiwan's machinery to make such a name for itself in the world. This is GPM's regulated clean room. Taiwan's semiconductor, computer, and consumer electronics industries have grown exponentially, and GPM has moved away from producing traditional machines to become one of the world's top providers of precision machinery.
设备在做的过程中里头，以前是黑手，很多油渍，很多油。那些油渍的过程是什么？是为了韧滑。现在呢，设备的精密度已经精密到不需要擦油，不需要韧滑油，因为你韧滑油不可以进无尘室。你一进无尘室了以后，它会产生挥发的油脂出来。这个挥发的油脂只要一沾到我们的产品上面，那产品就不良率就马上提高了。所以呢，以前的黑手，现在几乎在现场的每一个人穿的都是无尘室在操作或者在处理。其实这三十年的变化是完全不一样的。
所以所需要的人才就愈来愈多啊。譬如讲，以前可能是一般的这个学历的啊，高工的就会使你啊。但是尾啊发展到这个程度来，你需要愈来愈多专科的这个学历，大学的，甚至于硕士、博士这些人才一直加入。所以才有法度伫为民国七十几年了发展到即个民国九十几年，这二十几年中间，台湾的整个精密机械产业，伊的这个附加价值大为提高，规模嘛拢一直大型化起来。
Employees at Haiwan Corporation are attending a class on patent R&D. This company is the world's third largest producer of ball screws and hopes to be number one by the end of 2008. Its strengths lie in its people and strong R&D capabilities.
Machine research and normal research are not the same.它有长时间的累积要试用，所以它的马步要很稳啊。我们现在的策略是我们自己做一部分，那很主要的是我们跟大学或者研究单位一起去合作，从淡江、华范、台大、台科大、台北科大，一路到南边，最南边的就是中山大学，现在有20所大学，大概有30多个案子在进行。那这个部分大部分大学进行的是比较基础的研究，那应用的研究或者整合性就由我们这边来去承担。
Innovation and R&D have helped transform what was once a black hands industry. Haiwan Corporation has 3 R&D teams responsible for new products, machinery and production processes. The company ensures that the fruits of its hard labor are protected. Since its establishment in 1989, Haiwan has obtained over 200 patents.
这个组织呢，不是只有硬体买设备，那软体的研发跟人力的素质、想法，还有他的气质，他都会上来。如果有可能建立自己的品牌，长期去耕耘，如果企业要永续经营，这三点大概保得定。
We have seen how Taiwan's industry clusters have integrated upstream and downstream processes, forming tight economic units in which the flow of information and human talent stimulates innovation and the emergence of new technologies. From yachts to moth orchids, from saxophones to precision machinery, Taiwan's different clusters are flourishing as they help forge a new century and take on the world.